In this video, you will learn how to build and test an offline-enabled interface. Before getting started, remember that if offline is a requirement for your use case, you should create an offline-first design. This enables a consistent user experience and ensures data loss is avoided if the device loses internet connectivity. In the previous video, you met Kim, a rental inspector who uses an offline mobile-enabled inspection form. That form, which kicks off a process model, was built by a developer named Raul. Let's walk through the simple four-step process using Raul's example. The first step is to enable offline mobile. To do that, Raul first goes to the admin console. Under System Properties, he goes to Mobile. The Enable Offline Mobile box is already selected, confirming offline mobile is enabled in his environment. If the box was not selected, then Raul would check the box and click Save Changes. Raul can then enable offline mobile in an interface. Raul opened the interface, clicked the settings icon, then properties. From here, Raul selected Make Available Offline. Selecting the checkbox doesn't automatically optimize interfaces for offline use. It means instead, you should build your interfaces according to design best practices for offline interfaces. The second step is to build your interface according to data handling and compatibility best practices. Let's break this down by reviewing the current version of the move-in, move-out form Raul built to see how he preloaded data and used fully and partially compatible functions for this offline mobile experience. First, notice that Raul is using a record type as a rule input to display and capture data. You can use record type data types in offline interfaces, but there are a few differences you should be aware of, such as working with charts and grids. Go to Appian documentation to learn more. Next, let's switch to expression mode to take a closer look at the data saved to Raul's local variables. Raul made sure these local variables are loaded before the form layout, ensuring the data is available for an offline mobile experience. This is because after an interface's initial evaluation on the server, it no longer communicates with the server. Instead, the interface reevaluates without the server, so you need to preload data to your form so users can use it without the server. To do this, you will use local variables to query and store the data used throughout the interface. If you have a parent interface that is made up of child interfaces or rules, make sure that you are getting all of your data in the parent interface. Then pass this data to the child interface or rule using rule inputs. When building offline-enabled interfaces, you can use fully and partially compatible functions and components. Other functions that require connection to the server are incompatible and will cause an error if you use them. Let's first look at a partially compatible function example, which needs to be called at the top of the interface so the data can be loaded when initially communicating with the server. To get the name of the inspector, Raul created the inspector local variable. He used the logged in user function to get that value. So when the user has an internet connection, they can pull down on the interface and their username will be saved to that local variable. That value can then be used throughout the interface whether the user has internet access or not. Further down in Raul's interface, you can see a fully compatible example. Here, the ABank signature function can be used to save and display a homeowner signature. Since this function does not need to communicate with the server, it could be used anywhere in Raul's interface. When offline mobile is enabled on your interface, Appian will offer design guidance and help you ensure you use the correct functionality in the right place. For example, if I add a partially compatible function in the form layout instead of preloading the data before the form, Appian will guide me to use the correct functionality. You can also search for the Appian functions table on Appian's documentation and filter by offline mobile's compatibility. Let's also look at these different room local variables that capture and return reference data. Here, Raul is calling expression rules that use ABank query record type to return reference data. When the user selects a room, the different areas of that room they need to inspect are populated into this grid from the reference data. To keep your interfaces performant, you should only query and load the data needed for your users to work with that interface. you should use query filters to ensure only the necessary data is returned. The next step is to consider other parts of your app. You need to determine how users will access the forms you create. For the inspection form, which is a process start form that kicks off an action, Raul added it as a site page. Raul also needs to design the process model that interface is connected with. For tasks, consider how you want users to review them. You could use the mobile site task list that is included with your mobile application. Users would navigate to this list and review their available tasks, and then click a task to take action on it. You can also build a custom task list. Appian's documentation includes an offline mobile task report recipe, so you can quickly create your own. The last step we will cover is testing. To test an offline mobile experience, you need to do so from your mobile application. Using your computer or your mobile device's web browser is not sufficient, as it would not use the offline evaluator. Testing the experience using a mobile device on the mobile application will mimic your user's real-world experience. Before testing, you will need to download the Appian mobile application. You can download the app from your device's App Store. Make sure the mobile app is the same version or higher than your Appian environment for offline to work. You can find out more about Appian mobile account setup by searching Appian's documentation. Next, open the app from your device. You will be prompted to add your environment and log in. Now you can start testing. Once logged in, navigate to your site and open the page that contains your action. In this example, Raul went to the admin console and set this form as a start page for Kim's team. Next, pull down on the form to refresh the interface. This will ensure the local variables at the top of your interface have the necessary data. Next, you will input data into your form. To properly test, make sure your device is offline. An easy way to do this is to put the device in airplane mode. Technically, the offline evaluator will work the same when online, but it is a good idea to mimic a user's real-world experience. Input data into the form and submit. Be sure to test every single field to make sure users will not face errors when completing their offline form. Next, you want to confirm the form is listed under pending forms. Navigate to that section and confirm the form is there. The fourth step is to reconnect to the internet and check that the form got submitted. You can confirm this by checking the form is no longer under pending forms. To troubleshoot, check for incompatible functions or partially compatible functions set up to refresh. Also, review the interface expression to ensure the UI follows design best practices for offline mobile. In this video, you learned that offline apps should be designed for offline use first. You also learn the four steps to take to build and test an offline interface. Enable offline mobile. Build offline interfaces according to data handling and compatibility best practices. Consider and build other parts of your app. And test your offline mobile experience. Until next time, happy building, and check out the recommended resources in the description of this video.